Marksman! Marksman, they just released a new game mode into the beta. Go try it. Go play it. Just mess around with it. It's just like Search and Destroy. It's right up your alley. You're going to love it. It's not up my alley, okay? Cyber Attack. Essentially, the premise is you have to go and collect an EMP, and you take that EMP to the information site, and then you use the EMP to destroy the... You have to arm the EMP, and it destroys the information when it blows up, and you win the round, right? It sounds like Search and Destroy, except for the fact that if you die, you can be revived fairly quickly. The arm time and defuse time of the bomb is 1 second, and it seems super advantageous to just not play the objective. And almost, I played for about an hour, maybe an hour and a half. And I think in a total of an hour and a half, I saw the information, or the EMP, I'm sorry, get planted at the information 2 times. So 2 times out of probably, I don't know, 70 rounds? It's, no one's going to play. No one plays the objective. It doesn't make any sense to play the objective. It, you arm it in 1 second and you risk getting killed and you defuse it in 1 second. It's just, it's too, the objective is almost a non-factor. It basically doesn't matter. The real objective here is to get a kill and to hopefully not get your kill revived, because then if you died and you can't be revived, it was essentially a waste of your life. That's the real objective. The real objective is to kill players and then camp their body for 2 minutes straight so they can't be revived and hope that your entire team doesn't die, because if your entire team dies, then that means their entire team is revived, which means that leaves you in a 1v5 because they're all alive and you camped the one body you killed. It's not good. It basically means that you need even more of a team to help play, because if you have some bad players, you're at a severe disadvantage. You're going to notice, watch this round, for example, right? I have 3 different kill streaks. I start calling one in. It's the missile, right? I was like, oh, this is pretty good. I miss everybody, just a heads up. I suck with this thing. I haven't figured out the map and where I should go with it to hit people, so I'm not quite there yet. But I'm inside the cave. I like the cave because it's limited in lines of sight, and I'm trying to learn the lines of sight in this place before I move out and learn them in another area. So I start moving up. I'm trying to clear the cave, push through with this other player that's on my right in here. We're moving up. We're okay right now. Well, as we do this, you know, our team all dies. Right now it's a 2v5 on the other side of the map. They're all dead. Every player is dead. And then my teammate in the cave dies with me as well. Now it's a 1v5. Well, I might be able to beat the player in the cave, which puts me in a 1v4, but everybody outside the cave gets revived because my team is ass in that situation. Or they didn't pull it out, you know, their clutch, what they needed. It makes it basically impossible to clutch. You can't, there's no clutch factor. Which is one of the most epic parts of Search and Destroy, right? Like, your team is dead. It's a 1v2, 1v1. They're watching you. And you pull out, like, a sick play, and it's a clutch, right? It's sweet. You can't really do that in this. Because the second you kill somebody, they're revived if you have to go for another player. So I killed that guy, right? And I changed my routes to get into a new spot so they can't just flood me. Well, if I would have killed this guy down low, the guy up top would have been revived anyway. It's still a 1v5. Nothing changes. The clutch factor goes away. It basically is just a man-up advantage the whole time. When you're playing man-up advantages, it benefits the players who don't move as much, and it benefits the players who run as a group as much. So you can't really play solo very well, and you can't play in a clutched way. It's not good. It wasn't good in Ghosts. It's not good now. As I mentioned, I'm not super upset by it, because it's not like they're going to replace Search and Destroy with this, but they would rather try this in the beta than Search and Destroy, when this is obviously not Search and Destroy, and it's not as good either. So we move up with our team. This time I decided to go to the outside, right? Because all my team died on the outside last time. So, like, I'll play with them. I'll try to play out here with them. I'll try to help them out. We'll try to push and, like, revive effectively. I don't really know all the lines of sight, so I'm trying to peek a little bit, but I'm just kind of jitter peeking. So I'm, like, going in and out, just looking for someone to shoot at me and where they're shooting from. So he shot from the wall. I was able to aim down on him that time. FMJ, by the way, does not work very well in this game. I've been testing it. Doesn't work very well. FMJ right now is on the gun I'm using. My teammate walks out, though, and dies next to the fence, right? So I'm like, all right, well, shit. Let's see if I can get the revive. I want to help my teammate out. I would rather have the man-up advantage. So if I weaken this guy or get the kill, I can probably move up. I weaken him a bunch. The player is there to push him. I'm like, all right, I can probably push up now. They don't have any lines of sight on us. I'll lay down. I'll get the revive. We'll get our guy back, right? Easy. Nice. All right, I'll lay down. I accidentally pick his weapon up. I try to go for the revive. I'm sniped in the head from some guy sitting super far back. And I got punished for trying to help a bad player. I mean, my life is worth more than theirs. Always. Always. I'm not going to risk my life when I'm like 10-2 for somebody that's going 1-5 or 1-4 or 1-10. It's not worth it. Why should I put myself at at risk for somebody that's probably going to just get up and instantly die again when I have the chance to maybe get some kills and probably or maybe clutch the round out for our team or at least help us get the round win? Instead, I risk dying like that for a dude that is infinitely worse, and it's just not good. It's bad. It's not a good thing. Watch how fast he defuses, by the way. Right there. That was it. He killed my guy. He walked over. He touched the bomb. It was defused. Or the EMP, whatever, the bomb. So, I mean, I don't think search and rescue, they did change it, by the way. It's not exactly search and rescue. In search and rescue, you dropped a dog tag. That dog tag was then, if you hit it, it would revive the player around the person that did that. So it's not the exact same, but it's freaking close. It's really close. If I go over and stand on their body and hold down the button for like 3 seconds, they get revived. They're next to me. They revive with low HP, so they're basically one shot again. But and they get back to full health after like 10 seconds. But it's not search and destroy. It's not exactly what search and rescue was, but search and rescue wasn't good. This isn't good. And I'm just not happy with the choice that they made to do this. This is a great example of when it's beneficial, where if the guy on their team sniped this guy in search and destroy, he's dead. But because he was in a window long range, I can just revive him and his snipe was basically worthless. So it makes a lot of the plays that you make as like a clutch player or as a player that maybe carries the team or a solo player, it makes a lot of the plays that you make pretty much null. Pretty much useless. Here's a good example, right? People come up behind me. I kill one. I kill two. Awesome. All right. If I have to lay down here, and I do, and I get shot in the back like I did, now all the people that I just killed get all revived, right? I killed two people over there. The guy that killed me is going to go revive both of them. That double kill was worthless. It did nothing to help the team win. Didn't do anything. Now they're both up. Now it's a 5-2 again. It takes away the plays. It takes away the value of what you do as a player. I'm sorry, but that's what it does. It makes it feel like it's just like, what's the fucking point? That's what it makes it feel like. I'm better off getting one kill and sitting on that dude's body for 2 minutes straight. And then maybe I can make sure that a guy that I killed stays dead. It doesn't feel like an objective-based game mode, at least in the objective that they created. It feels like an objective-based game mode is in like, I'm playing this like it's kill confirmed, kind of. I killed a dude, his tag is there, and it stays there for 2 minutes, and if they go grab it, he's revived, otherwise he stays dead. I have to make sure they don't get that tag. That's basically what it is. It's not a arm the EMP and destroy the information. It is a, I killed one dude. I'm going to sit here and watch his dumbass body so nobody revives him. And that way the guy that I killed stays dead. That is the objective. That is the true objective of this game mode. And it's just not very fun, right? That's not really an objective-based game mode in my mind. It's not good, but maybe you really like it. Not my thing. Maybe you like it. I think most of you guys, if you came for my channel because you liked Search and Destroy, you probably won't like it. But go ahead and give it a shot. Let me know what you think in the comment section. Do you think it's better than Search and Rescue? Do you think it's worse than Search and Rescue? Would you like it more than S&D? Would you prefer Search and Destroy instead? What do you like? What do you dislike? I've explained my side pretty thoroughly here. And I made a play here where I got a couple kills and I got the revive, which cool, but it's just, I feel like it's still, even then, the guy that I just revived died. Like, why did I risk my life to revive a dude that died 2 seconds later? It just doesn't make sense. So, let me know what you think. I hope you guys enjoyed the rest of the video here. I'll let it play out. You guys can see the final round. This goes to the 5 rounds, if you didn't know. Sorry, it doesn't go to 6. So, 1-5 rounds wins. And I think you can play it on all maps at the moment, including a new map that they released today in the beta, so there's a new map as well you can play and enjoy. There's no new levels, you're still level 10, so you're still limited by your level, but you do at least have a new map, new game mode. So, give it a shot. Let me know what you think. I'm not happy with it. I'm still, like I said, I'm not upset. I want to repeat myself. I'm not upset. It's not replacing Search and Destroy. I'm just giving you my opinion. This is what it is. I don't think it's very good. I'm still going to stick with Search and Destroy when it's out. That's what I want to play. So enjoy the video. Thank you for watching. Drop a sub, drop a like, whatever, if you want. If you don't, it's fine. I'll see you later.
Home bloody and empty-handed. Good work.